There is nothing better than creating something in a visual effect graph. Today I want to create a dot grid with interaction and explore a bunch of extensions. It's going to be a lot of fun, so let's dive in. Firstly, make sure to install VFX graph or open HDRP project. Create a VFX graph and give it a name. I recommend using a layout for writing notes that make it simple and helps you keep track of your work. Don't forget to drag the VFX to the scene. Now let's clean up unnecessary nodes. Keep the orient face camera plane, but remove others. You can set the particle count as you like. I prefer a higher number, like 1000, and use a single burst for spawning all particles at once. For positioning each particle, I want to use sequential 3-dimensional, which will create a 3D grid for setting up the position for each particle for us. Set count X and Z to 32 and Y to 1. And add some offset. This will make our grid something like a plane. To represent these particles as circle objects, there are many ways to do it, but I will use a VFX shader graph. For that, we need to enable experimental operators and blocks from preferences to access this feature. Create a shader VFX. Create an ellipse and set the width and height and connect it to the base color and alpha. Go back to VFX and attach the shader. It works great, but we can set the color for our circle. So we need to put the color in dot shader. To set the color, multiply it by the ellipse and connecting it to the base color. Here we get another property called a particle color, which is the color we have created. And we can use the get attribute color and connect it to the particle color to set the color from blocks. Now let's change the color between two colors using the lerp node. The first input and the next one should be your colors. While S or T slides between them. For those that are unfamiliar with these nodes, refer to my previous video, which provides a comprehensive guide to mastering nodes in shader graph and visual effect graph. Create a sphere, mostly because we need a point in our world to use it as a target or our player. Also, if you can't see the sphere gizmos, select the visual effect object. Then get a distance from each particle with this sphere. There are two nodes that we can do this. One is the distance float, which will work well. but another one is the distant sphere, which is great because it is made for calculating distance only for this for the sphere. After that, we can use a smooth step node and a radius for T or S, and Y can be our distance but plus a small number. If we connect this to LERP, it creates an inside red and outside a green color. What exactly do we want? It has a feather color. If we don't want the feather color, we can delete the smooth step and use a compare node to compare the distance and radius. If the distance is bigger than the radius, so return 1 and otherwise return 0. To achieve the animate color, we should put these nodes to update particles, not in the output. So in the update, we create a custom attribute and name it select. Composition to overwrite, random to off, and attribute type to float. Now multiply the output by speed. And time delta time. Also put the false value to -1 so we could have the animation to the center of the sphere. Then add this value to the current select value. For that, get the custom attribute and put exactly the select name. The name should be the same. After we add the current value to the next value, we want to clamp the output to 0 and 1. For that, we can use a clamp node or simply saturate node. The whole point was to store a number which we name it select, add the select to the animated value, and again set that output to select. Duplicate the select attribute for LERP. Now if we move the sphere, we get the cool transition. In the output, create a block and the name is set size random from curve. Set the sample mode to custom using select for sample time and adjust the animation curve. Let's go and expose all the properties we want. If we want to change the position of the sphere via the code, we should expose the sphere too. In a script, you can change this position, for example, by setting the position to your character's position. Also, there is another cool way. You can connect this property to another object by using VFX Property Binder and by creating a sphere and disabling the mesh renderer because we only want the sphere collider. Then in the VFX Property Binder, add the sphere collider. The property name should be the same as above and set the target to this sphere. Now with controlling the sphere object, the property will change too. Let's see some extensions. First, I duplicate the .vfx so it remains as the same and I make changes to this one. So I want to make this in 3D objects, for example a cube. We're changing the set position as sequential. We can create any 3D grid or object. Another extension is we can delete the sequential and use another node for setting the position, like using mesh. It uses the vertex, surface or edge of the mesh to place the particles. It is so cool, you can do a lot with this block. Also, you can use a skinned mesh renderer. I have this 3D character So instead of set the position mesh, use the set position skinet mesh. This skinet mesh has almost more than 50,000 vertices. We have to increase the capacity and burst count. I hope this tutorial was helpful. Play around with it to see different results. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications for our next video. Thanks for watching and see you next time.